How do 3D films work? 3D films, obviously, aren't really three-dimensional. If you walk up to the cinema screen, you will find it as flat as it ever was, which is flatter than the Bonneville Salt Flats. It's all a trick. Your brain is fooled into seeing two different two-dimensional pictures as one three-dimensional picture. And this is exactly what your eyes and your brain do in the real three-dimensional world, all thanks to something called stereoscopic vision. Stand still and look at a stationary object near to you. Now cover each eye in turn with the comedy pirate eye patch from A Christmas Cracker. You'll notice that the position of the object shifts slightly as you move the eye patch from one side to the other. You can do this by just closing one eye or the other, to be honest. Your brain combines these two images as one, but at the same time, it's using the difference between the two images to work out how far away the thing is. This is what's known as your depth perception. It's why we have two eyes and not just one. And it's why, if you cover one eye up, you'll find it much harder to play something like table tennis. 3D films work by delivering a different image to each eye, so your brain perceives depth to the picture. The old-fashioned way of filtering what each eye sees is with those idiotic cardboard spectacles with one red lens and one blue lens. The red lens only lets red light through, the blue lens only lets blue light through. So the film contains red images and blue images of the same scene, but shot through two different lenses. This is exactly how your eyes work. And then your brain performs its usual trick of reassembling the picture with depth. The only problem with this is that the colours are pretty horrible, and one arm of the glasses usually breaks off. A more sophisticated version of the same system uses polarised light instead of colours. In essence, polarised light has orientation, so glasses with two different polarising lenses can divide up the picture as before. An even more sophisticated version uses something called an active shutter system. The glasses now block the eyes alternately, while alternate frames in the film are received by the unblocked eye. As long as the frames change quickly enough, your brain doesn't notice that this is happening because of something called persistence of vision. The way an image remains in your brain for a fraction of a second, even after it's gone. But the glasses are quite complicated. Interestingly, 3D films have been the next big thing in cinema several times throughout its history, and usually when cinemas felt under threat. So in the 1950s with the rise of television, in the 1980s with the development of videotape, and in the 2000s as home cinema and downloadable films became affordable. In fact, the first 3D film was shown in New York in 1915. No one was very bothered then either. Nathan Simpson has written in and he has asked me, how do hard drives work? And I will answer that just as soon as I found out.